Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
You're watching South Asia Newsnight, and here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 28th of May. PM Modi terms reservation key issue in elections, calls opposition biggest enemy of minorities. People in India and Pakistan struggle to cope with heat wave. And Russia invites Afghanistan's Taliban to major economic forum. And now for all the details. Days ahead of the final phase of India's gigantic elections, Indian Prime Minister Narendra Modi on Tuesday slammed the India Alliance and said the opposition bloc is indulging in vote bank politics, undermining the constitutional rights of marginalized communities. In an exclusive interview to ANI, the Prime Minister said, while the opposition parties call themselves the well-wishers of SC-ST communities, but in reality, they are the staunch enemies. He added, for the sake of vote bank politics, educational institutions were converted into minority institutions, ending protections and reservations for backward communities. Highlighting the recent judgment by Calcutta High Court invalidating the OBC certifications issued in West Bengal after 2010, PM Modi said the judgment brought into light the atrocities committed by the opposition related to reservation. When the High Court's judgment came, it became clear that such a big fraud was taking place. But what is even more unfortunate is that for vote bank politics, now they are also abusing the judiciary, he added.
एक भारत के संविधान की मूल भावना का हनन हो रहा है, संविधान की मर्यादाओं को तार तार कर दिया जा रहा है, और वो भी अपनी वोट बैंक की राजनीति के लिए, कि जो लोग इतने बड़े दलितों के हितैषी अपने आप को कहते हैं, आदिवासियों के हितैषी कहते हैं, वे हकीकत में उनके घोर दुश्मन हैं।
Talking about Article 370, PM Modi said the defunct article was neither the agenda of the people of Kashmir nor of the country, but only of 4 to 5 families. He said it was for the benefit of the dynast politics that they had built a wall of 370 and used to say if the article is removed, there will be fire. After the removal of 370, there is a feeling of more unity. The feeling of belongingness is increasing among the people of Kashmir, and hence its direct result is also visible in elections and tourism, he added. Residents in parts of North India and neighbouring Pakistan are reeling under intense heatwave conditions, with temperatures hovering around 50 degrees Celsius in some areas. Take a look.
Residents across India's northwest and Rajasthan state are facing intense heatwave conditions, with forecasts suggesting no respite soon. Locals could be seen walking with their heads covered for protection from the scorching sun on Monday, while some sought refuge by taking rest under tree shade. The weather department has predicted more heatwave days than normal up until June this year. Meanwhile, the Border Security Force, BSF, continued patrolling along the India-Pakistan border in the desert region of Rajasthan's Jaisalmer amid the torrid heat wave conditions.
इस हद तक गर्मी है, इससे भी हम माप सकते हैं कि वहाँ पर ड्यूटी करना अत्यंत दुभर हो गया है. लेकिन जैसा पता है आपको कि BSF बनी बॉर्डर के लिए है. हमारे लोगों में वो जज्बा है क्योंकि सरकार की तरफ से एक हमको जिम्मेदारी दी गई है.
Meanwhile, in Pakistan's Mohenjo-Daro, a town in Sindh province known for archaeological sites that date back to the Indus Valley civilization, temperatures rose as high as 52.2 degrees Celsius on Monday, a senior weather official said. Mohenjo-Daro is a small town that experiences extremely hot summers and mild winters and low rainfall, but its limited markets, including bakeries, tea shops, mechanics, electronic repair shops, and fruit and vegetable sellers are usually bustling with customers. But with the current heat wave, shops are seeing almost no footfall.
Meanwhile, Pakistan held funerals on Monday for 7 soldiers who were killed during exchanges of fire with militants in the country. The Pakistan Army said 5 Pakistani soldiers were killed in gun battles with the Islamist militants in the country's northwest bordering Afghanistan early on Monday. The deaths were in addition to 2 other soldiers, including an officer who were killed on Sunday in an operation against the militants on the outskirts of northwestern city of Peshawar. A statement said a total of 23 militants had also been killed in the last 2 days in what the army described as 3 intelligence-based operations on their hideouts in Pakistan close to the Afghan border. The militants were involved in numerous terrorist activities against security forces and civilians. The military, however, did not identify what group they belonged to. Moving on, residents near Neelam Valley Road in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir are worried over landsliding in the area where 2 electricity towers are likely to collapse. But the authorities are least concerned despite several pleas. A report.
Locals in Pakistan-occupied Jammu and Kashmir held a protest recently over landsliding on a hill near the Neelam Valley Road, where 2 electricity transmission towers are likely to collapse. The protesters lamented that it seems the Wapda and other concerned authorities are waiting for a major tragedy to happen because they have ignored all their pleas so far to address their concerns.
The tower is placed. It is about 2 years of sliding. पीछे से कटाई की वजह से भी और उस तरफ मुकम्मल इसकी दरारें बढ़ चुकी हैं. उस तरफ तकरीबन 40-50 घर हैं और ये मेन शहरा है जो पूरे राज्य कश्मीर की है. तो ये किसी भी वक्त किसी बड़े हादसे का सबब बन सकती है. उसे अपील है कि खुदा रहा इस मामले को सीरियस लें. ये कोई मामूली बात नहीं है. ये 1,25,000 रुपये भी जा रही है. एबटाबाद में भी मैंने रब्ता किया, रिटर्न भी दिया उनको सबको, लेकिन अभी तक किसी ने कोई इसमें कोई रिस्पॉन्स नहीं दिया.
People in POJK have been waiting for years for a better administration that could work for their welfare and the region's development. But the apathetic attitude of the government has worsened the condition.
Russia has invited Afghanistan's Taliban to its biggest annual economic forum as Moscow moves to remove a ban on the Islamist movement. Since Kabul fell to Taliban in 2021, Moscow has been slowly building ties with the Taliban, though the movement is still officially outlawed in Russia. Zamir Kabulov, director of the Second Asia Department at the Russia Foreign Ministry, said that an invitation to attend the June 5 to 8 St. Petersburg International Economic Forum had been extended to the Taliban. He said Afghan leaders were traditionally interested in the purchase of oil products. Western investors seeking a slice of Russia's vast resource wealth have now been replaced by businesses from China, India, Africa and the Middle East. In 2003, Russia formally labeled the Taliban a terrorist organization, though it had periodic informal contacts with the movement. Sri Lankan President Ranil Wickremesinghe will contest the presidential poll to seek re-election and will announce his candidacy in the next 2 weeks. Tourism Minister Hanin Fernando said on Monday as he exuded confidence that he will certainly win. The Island Nations Election Commission earlier this month said the presidential election would be conducted between September 17th and October 16th. The ruling Sri Lanka People's Front, which has the current parliamentary majority, had pressed Wickremesinghe to hold the parliamentary election ahead of the presidential poll. Wickremesinghe is yet to announce his candidacy despite declarations by 2 other main opposition leaders. Since taking over, the president has steered the economy to safety by securing an IMF bailout. And in a sharp response, Bangladesh Army Chief General SM Shafiuddin Ahmed has denied allegations of human rights violations by Bangladeshi troops in the UN peacemaking mission, as he demanded evidence of Bangladeshi personnel failing in discipline during UN operation. The stern remarks came in response to a documentary report by German media outlet Deutsche Welle. Bangladesh Army has served in 43 missions worldwide with over 6,000 peacemakers currently deployed. Can anyone provide a single example of us violating human rights or failing in discipline during these missions? General Ahmed was quoted as saying by news agency UNB. He added that such allegations against Bangladesh troopers are biased and motivated. He said they expressed frustration in the documentary on why UN headquarters took no step. The UN will take action only when they will find evidence against us. That's all in tonight's edition. We will see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
TAG TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.